I can see the stag.
Well, Sean and I have been talking about this trip for, well, a year. Last year I was telling him about stags roaring and what that's all about and the limited amount of deer stalking that I've done, and he was just intrigued by it. And he's got a good mate, well, his best mate at school, Max, and him and his dad go hunting all the time. Sean gets all these stories from Max and he's keen as, and I'm really keen too because, well, hunting's still pretty new to me, and it's something that Sean and I can go and do together where we're probably both equally as excited.
Just leaving Kerikeri on our way to pick up Glenn and Max. We've got a long drive, but we're geared up for it.
We're making the long run down all the way from our home in Kerikeri. There's me, Sean, his best mate Max, and Max's dad Glenn. And I know Glenn through, well, through the rugby club. Pretty much how you know everyone around Kerikeri. And we've got a long trip ahead of us, all the way down to the Wairarapa. So first stop off we make is in Auckland. Catch up with my old mate, haven't seen him since his big fight.
So we've made it as far as Auckland. The young fellas needed a bit of a pit stop, so stopped in and ho! Oh,
who's this fella?
Hey!
Hey,
are you hunting?
Yeah, we're going hunting. Yeah, well, we'll drop you back some venison.
Space in the car for me.
That was pretty cool for Max and Shaw. And I tell you what, kids, if you want a role model, someone who works hard, that man Joseph Parker. So model yourself on him and you'll do all right.
Whew, that's a beautiful view of Auckland in the rearview mirror.
We stayed the night in Taupo, and after a bit of a rest up, we've got another 5 hours ahead of us. Final stop off on the road is at Hunting and Fishing in Palmy to grab our last minute supplies.
Out there doing it.
And we go off with our nice, shiny, clean, new looking Can-Am to get it out into the bush.
Getting close now.
We get out onto the block and I'm thinking, well, first night, we're just going to get settled into the hut, stoke the fire up and get all geared up for the morning, but nah, some stags still roaring over in the gully. Now, we're a little bit late for the roar, and that's mainly because we had to wait for the school holidays to come around. I couldn't really justify ripping Shaw out of school for a week. Maybe I could if he was up to date with his schoolwork and he wasn't in trouble with his teachers and the vice principal, but he has been, so he had to stay at school for the week, and we got down here and everyone's saying, oh, you're too late for the roar, but we get up onto this bluff and we can hear some stags roaring on our first stop. And man, that gets you excited.
Got the GoPro.
Oh, sure.
I'm just so excited.
For anyone that sort of doesn't know what the stags roaring is all about, is, well, it's the big male stags, and they're basically marking out their turf. So they're trying to gather up as many hinds as they can, and they're going to want to make sure that there's no other stags around. So they're almost like one stag will roar, and if another one roars back and says, nah, hang on, it's like one saying, oi, brah, this is my patch and these are my ladies. And another one comes back and brah, no, I've got ladies too and these are mine and this is my patch. And if one stag doesn't really roar back, and he might just skirt away and be happy with his one or two hinds. But if he thinks he's tough, he'll go and take on the other stag and they get into big scraps. Just like really what humans have been doing, you know, since the dawn of time, fighting over land and woman.
Oh, there's another one. There. This one. Go down to the right. Oh, and then.
We've got the guys out on this ledge here and we're looking out over a clearing, and we're able to see deer coming out to feed at night, and it's a good opportunity for these guys to see deer without getting too excited. And you know, there's rules with hunting, particularly when there's firearms involved, to just take our time, take a look, see what's there, and you don't have to shoot them, particularly not these ones, because they're over the fence on the neighbour's property and that would be poaching. So we've just got the boys checking things out.
Black ones are right there.
There's fallow deer, there's pigs. And there's also a red stag down there somewhere.
We just decided to walk along the track a wee bit, and just down below us we can see a stag, and he's got a couple of hinds with him. About 90 metres away, perfect opportunity perhaps, right on our first couple of hours here, for one of the young fellas to shoot their first stag.
I can see its head. It's a bird. Yeah, sure. A frog.
We decided to pass that one up pretty much because it just seemed too easy. You know, particularly Shaw, I really want him to earn this. I sort of don't want to turn up here, walk 300 yards from the Can-Am and say, oh look, there's a stag there, can't see us, give Shaw a rifle and he bowls it over. The hunting's about the experience, you know. I'm pretty confident in this block that we're in, we're going to get some meat to take out of here. And when we get the right animals at the right time, the boys can take their shot.
Yeah, I can see the stag. He's sidled.